this Malaysian Sustainable Palm Oil certification throughout the state. First of all, they are mainly retired but very experienced professionals from the various, from the previous job, in the oil palm plantation. We need to seek their help to go into interior area to reach out to the small planters, small holders, to explain to them the importance of get MSPO certification, to explain to the farmers, so they are willing to do that. And for the MSPO certification for next year, Finance Ministry has given us 30 million to do the certification for MSPO for smallholders, but we know that this amount is not enough. So we must show that we have progressed in our efforts to push for MSPO certification. Then we'll apply for more funding from the federal government and Finance Ministry, after we have shown results. Just a little statistic for the media. As at 31st October this year, 24.4% of the total area of oil palm plantation, oil palm area in Sarawak has obtained the MSPO certification. 24.4%. That means 359,810 hectares of the land in Sarawak, oil palm plantation in Sarawak, that obtained MSPO certification. So 24.4% as of now is still not enough. That's why, as we want to push for 100% certification by end of 2019, we need the cooperation of all NGOs, we need cooperation of the state government to work together with the ministry in order to achieve that. The idea of MSPO is we want to show to the world, Malaysia, our oil palm estate, oil palm growers, we have good agricultural practices. Our palm oil will be, you have the traceability in future, and we want to make our Malaysian palm oil the first class oil, the five star oil in the international market. We hope that through certifying all our oil palm plantation, then the whole value chain of the oil palm industry, we can brand Malaysian palm oil with a better image. Okay, that is for our meeting for today. Any question?
Well, why it's so important to obtain MSPO?
MSPO is a kind of standard that we want to implement to the the full value chain of the oil palm.
What I understand is without this MSPO, these European countries will not buy this palm oil from Malaysia.
As of now, our top number one importer of Malaysian palm oil is India. Followed by EU. EU ranking two. The third is China, as of now. Although for my ministry, under MPOC, Malaysia Palm Oil Council, we are at the moment exploring a lot of new markets. Our new market include Philippines, include African countries, the Northern African countries, include some of the Middle Eastern countries. So we are working very hard to explore new markets. But and also not to forget that from China, after the visit of Prime Minister to China, there are a lot of inquiries about palm oil and also the palm-based product, including biomass of the oil palm plantation. I met a lot of companies starting to make inquiries. So you can say that at this stage MSPO is not being recognized, but this is a government initiative. So in the end, if we can reach 100% certification of a whole oil palm plantation, we can start negotiating with EU, our purchaser, and also even the government to tell them that whatever they accuse us, we already trying our very best to fulfill. There is no more reason for them to boycott our Malaysian palm.
What is our Malaysian aspiration for this? You say Sarawak is 24.4%
certified as of now.
total areas in Sarawak certified.
The total area certified?
Yes, in Sarawak.
Okay,
but what about Malaysia? What's your percentage?
The whole, Sarawak or Malaysia first?
No, you say 34.4% for Sarawak, of the total areas certified.
In Sarawak?
What about the whole Malaysia?
Okay, for whole Malaysia, we have 5.8 million hectares of the oil palm area. So far, 22%.
22.
For the whole Malaysia, 22%.
So, Sarawak is higher.
Yeah, it's 1.26 million hectares.
You say India is number one.